We welcome you to week five of the high school football season. We are back here at Dwight G. Sadler Field for 2A District 5 action between the Mid-Prairie Golden Hawks and the Camanche Indians. From Wellman, we welcome you into the broadcast. Dylan Anderson, along with Jimmy Nash, making his Wellman Access TV debut. Jimmy, welcome to the team.
Thank you.
And really a big game for both teams. Mid-Prairie is 1-3. They've lost three in a row, including the 49-31 loss to Mount Vernon a week ago. And Camanche has not won a game yet this year. They're 0-4 overall and 0-1 in District 5 play. They had a game against Williamsburg last week. They lost 55-7. And it's a big game for the Mid-Prairie Golden Hawks as they try to get back into that win column after three straight losses.
And something that Mid-Prairie is going to have to do, it's moving the ball and obviously passing. That's been a little bit of a struggle, but I mean, as long as they're passing the ball, they'll be good. Camanche, on the other hand, I mean, it's been rough to say the least. Starting quarterback Krieger with two touchdowns and seven interceptions. So those seven interceptions tell me that if Camanche wants to win and be competitive, they're going to have to win the turnover battle and protect the ball.
And as a whole this year, Camanche scored a total of 13 points in their four games. And they've also given up quite a few points, close to 200 points by only scoring 13 on offense. So the big key for Camanche is offense. As Jimmy mentioned, their quarterback, Baylor Krieger, has two touchdowns compared to seven interceptions, and Krieger is also Comanche's leading rusher, 51 carries for 102 yards. So that is our little pregame spiel. Some other games in 2A District 5 we're looking at. Obviously, we got the game here in Wellman between Comanche and Mid-Prairie. Williamsburg, which is Mid-Prairie's opponent next week, they will be traveling to Minneapolis. West Liberty will be at Anamosa, and Mount Vernon will travel to Northeast. So those are the other 2A District 5 games. So we will be back for the kickoff between the Golden Hawks and the Indians. You're watching Wellman Access TV. We are set for kickoff here in Wellman between Mid-Prairie and Camanche. Camanche won the toss, and they have elected to receive the opening kickoff. Mid-Prairie in their traditional home black top and black pants with the gold lettering, and Camanche in their traditional road uniforms, their white tops, white pants, and blue helmets. One thing we did forget to mention in the pregame show, it is homecoming here in Wellman. They had a presentation before the game with a couple members of the class of 1966 making a donation to the Mid-Prairie Foundation, and we'll have the homecoming court at halftime, and also the Golden Hawk mascot making an appearance. And from what it sounds like, this is kind of a once in a blue moon thing. Came out of hibernation. The Golden Hawk making an appearance tonight in Wellman. As we get set for kickoff, Taryn Jacoby getting ready to kick off to the Indians. As we get week five of the high school football season underway. And the kick will sail into the end zone for a touchback. We've seen that quite a bit this year from Taryn Jacoby. And Camanche will start first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Again, Camanche quarterback Baylor Krieger, who's a sophomore, thrown for 357 yards and two touchdowns, but he also has thrown seven interceptions. So that is something to watch out for, the turnovers from this Indians team.
Not exactly the ratio you want to see. You want to see that number flipped in an ideal world.
As Krieger will line up in the shotgun with Colby Snodgrass lined up alongside him in a four wide receiver set. Krieger hands off to Snodgrass, and he will get stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
A little bit of a odd formation in terms of a run play, going four wide and running up straight up the middle. But Mid-Prairie was prepared for it, and they just gang tackled him at the line of scrimmage.
No gain on the play, second down and 10. Again, Krieger in the shotgun. Snodgrass lined up alongside. Krieger rolling out to his right, trying to toss it out to his running back, but he could not get the ball off, and he will get tackled in the backfield. It looked like number 53, Jared Miller, was the main guy in on that tackle for Mid-Prairie. It looks like about a loss of two in that play. So it'll bring up third down and 12 for Camanche. In four wide receiver formation, Krieger in the shotgun, Snodgrass lined up alongside. Snap was mishandled, and Jason, too, was all over that tackle. Shot there by the 5'10", 200-pound junior linebacker who ran his way through that offensive line and got the tackle.
Just timed the snap count perfectly. Almost got caught with a little bit of a neutral zone infraction, but anyway, perfect timing by two, and he got the quarterback sack.
The kick is off from Camanche, and it'll take a Mid-Prairie bounce, and it will land in Camanche territory to be marked down at about the 47-yard line. And that's where the Golden Hawks start their first possession of the game. Looks like there's a flag along the Camanche sideline. That's going to be against Camanche.
That's a sideline warning.
It's a sideline warning, so there will be no yardage. But they get another sideline warning, and believe that'll be a 15-yard penalty. So that is something to watch out for through the duration of this game. And Mid-Prairie starting their first drive in Camanche territory. So we get our first look tonight at Mid-Prairie quarterback Carson Gingrich, who had a nice game last week against Mount Vernon, threw for three touchdowns. But ultimately, Golden Hawks came a little bit short as Gingrich hands off to his tailback. That's Ricky Vargas. Vargas himself had a nice game last week against Mount Vernon. He had 23 carries for 185 yards. A nice
efficient game for him as well.
Yeah, we're kind of used to seeing this from Ricky Vargas. If you give him any amount of space, he's going to take advantage of it, and he is very quick. That first initial burst of speed. Second down and 8-4 Mid-Prairie. Again, Gingrich hands off to Vargas. Vargas finds a hole and has some daylight. 30, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, Ricky Vargas. 55 yards to the house.
Credit to the offensive line with the perfect block, and he found the hole. Also credit to Ricky Vargas being very shifty on the play.
At 55 yards, Ricky Vargas all the way to the house. And two plays into the drive, Mid-Prairie is on the board. Taryn Jacoby on to attempt the PAT, and Carson Gingrich will be the holder. High snap, kick is up, and it is good from Taryn Jacoby. 9:45 left here in the first quarter. Your score, Mid-Prairie 7, Camanche 0. Well, we have a moment. We'd like to thank some sponsors for making Mid-Prairie football possible here on Wellman Access TV. Hills Bank for all your banking needs. Wellman Family Practice, who reminds you they are accepting new patients. Kelowna Cooperative Technology Company and the Wellman Telephone Cooperative bring you this portion of Golden Hawk football on Wellman Access TV. Well, Jimmy, two plays, and Ricky Vargas already has a score. 55 yards to the house. A nice first offensive drive for a team that at times this year has been struggling to move the ball offensively.
And just getting that first initial touchdown and having it be so quick, the confidence on the Mid-Prairie sideline have to be very high right now.
And the Golden Hawks got into kind of a shootout last week against Mount Vernon. They had at one point a 24-21 lead against a top five team in Class 2A in Mount Vernon. But a late punt return at the end of the third quarter, and the Mustangs ultimately pulled away for the 49-31 win. But a nice start offensively here for Mid-Prairie as Taryn Jacoby gets set to kick off once again. It's a low kick, and it's going to be picked up by the return man for Camanche. So it's going to be number two. Eric Campy on the return, the 6'1", 160-pound sophomore on the return for Camanche. Another story for Camanche. It's like they only had about 21 players dressed for tonight's game. There's a lot more than 21 names on this program. So we'll see if the numbers game starts to become an issue for the Indians, who, again, are 0-4 on the young season. As quarterback lines up in the shotgun, and we're going to have a penalty flag here.
Penalty flag on the field.
We have a false start here against Camanche. See referees converge to make sure they get the call right. And it indeed will be false start
on the Indians.
That'll move them back 5 yards. So we'll have first and 15 from their own 15-yard line. As the Indians try to muster something offensively after a quick three and out on their first offensive possession.
And starting with a penalty on before they even snapped the ball is not exactly the ideal way you want to start your possession if you're Camanche.
So we see Kruger lining up in the shotgun. And he gets met by Levi Dua. A fumble on the play. Looks like Kruger got on top of it. But Levi Dua was a man on a mission on that play. And he got to Kruger and got the ball loose, but just could not get that fumble. But nonetheless, nice play by the Iowa commit.
Absolutely. And he just bull rushed the left tackle and got past them. And was a man on a mission, as you said, and he almost took the quarterback out.
Second and 15. Second and out, and a lot longer than that for Mid-Prairie. Kruger back to pass. It is intercepted by Carter Reiner. He's at the 10, at the 5, and he will get into the end zone for a Mid-Prairie touchdown. Carter Reiner on the pick 6.
Almost bobbled it. He bobbled it at first, corralled the ball, and broke a few tackles on his way to the end zone for 6.
And 3 minutes and 7 seconds into the game, Mid-Prairie already has 2 touchdowns. Taryn Jacoby on to attempt a PAT. Carson Gingrich will hold once again. Jacoby so far perfect for the year on PATs. Snap is good. The kick is up, and it is good from Taryn Jacoby. 8:53 left here in the first quarter. Your score, Mid-Prairie 14 and Camanche 0. Talk about a nice start on both sides of the ball. You get an offensive touchdown and a defensive touchdown. And if you're head coach Pete Cavanaugh, you have to be loving what you're seeing right now from this Golden Hawks football team.
You're getting it from both sides of the ball, and as you said, absolutely have to be loving it right now.
And again, Reiner had a big interception last week against Mount Vernon. And, again, making another impact on the defensive side of the ball. That is the third interception of the year for Connor Rainier. And it is the second pick 6. Ricky Vargas also had one in week 1 against Eliza Muscatine. And game was, so far, Mid-Prairie's only win of the season. And again, Rainier was our Freeman's Foods Player of the Game last week. We'll see who it is at the end of this game. We'll give you our pick this week for our Freeman's Foods Player of the Game at the conclusion of this battle between the Golden Hawks and the Indians as Jacoby gets set to kick off once again. High end over end kick. And then we'll get into the end zone for another touchback. So the Golden Hawks as a whole are clicking on all cylinders right now. And the defense looks like it's overmatching the Camanche offense.
Absolutely. And, I mean, 2 plays on offense, 1 touchdown. More plays on defense. They get a defensive touchdown as well. So really, as we've been saying in the past few minutes, just all around a solid game put together by Mid-Prairie so far.
Krieger lining up in the shotgun with a four wide receiver set, and Snodgrass lined up alongside him. Krieger back to pass. The pass is caught by Hampton Grimm, the 5'9 senior wide receiver. Is good enough for a first down. Gingrich on the tackle for Mid-Prairie. The gain of 13. It'll be first and 10 from the 33. So far, we're seeing a lot of basically the exact same formation in every single play for Camanche. The four wide receiver set. Krieger hands off to his tailback Snodgrass, and he will get stuffed in the backfield by a host of Mid-Prairie defenders.
And going back to the passing play on first down, you had a perfect route ran by number 7, Hampton Grimm. Perfect throw by the quarterback, Baylor Krieger, and moved the ball, and then that first down play right there, just a little bit of a broken play. Bad blocking on the right side of the offensive line, and we have second and 12.
Loss of two on that play as Krieger will keep it himself, try to get to the sidelines, and he will get tackled. It's like Keaton Dua on the tackle for Mid-Prairie. May get back to the original line of scrimmage. And give him one. So it'll be about third and 11 for Camanche at their own 32. Again, we'll see the... now we have an empty backfield and a three wide receiver set. Two to the left, one to the right. And Krieger avoiding the pressure. He's going to take it himself. And he will stop short of the first down marker. Nice job by Krieger avoiding the pressure. First off from Levi Dua.
Tackled by Gingrich.
And it's going to be about 2 yards short of that first down marker. So we'll see what the Indians do here. Down 14-0. Not even about 5 minutes into the game.
It's a really good decision there by Hampton Grimm to not throw the ball into any more trouble and eventually dig his team into a deeper hole. And very good by mobility by him as well.
And they're going to go for it here. Fourth and two from the Camanche 41. Krieger in the shotgun with the four wide receiver set. Low snap. And Krieger, and he's not going to be able to avoid the pressure. Levi Dua on the sack for Mid-Prairie, and the Golden Hawks will take over on downs inside Camanche territory. It'll be first and 10 from what looks like the Camanche 33-yard line.
And again, the left side of that offensive line by Camanche right now just getting overpowered by Levi Dua and company, and it's eventually they're going to have to make a switch on whether you want to double him or just everyone on that defensive line.
Gingrich sending Justin Schwartz in motion, and he'll take the handoff. Get to the sidelines, there's a flag. There's going to be either a holding or a block in the back against Mid-Prairie, and Levi Dua will be the guilty party. It's like a legal block in the back on Mid-Prairie, so that will move them back 10 yards. It'll be first down and 20. Dua got a little bit, a little too much jersey there. Nonetheless, a nice block there. Would have set up a nice run there by Justin Schwartz, but it is all for naught. So it'll be first down and long here for Mid-Prairie. Ball will be marked at the Camanche 43-yard line, so it'll be first down and 20 for the Golden Hawks. It's a three wide receiver formation. One to the left, two to the right, and Vargas in the backfield. He tossed to Vargas. Gets a couple blocks, tries to get to the sidelines. Breaks a couple tackles and gets to about the 30-yard line. Nice run there by Ricky Vargas. Like gain of about 12 or 13 yards. And there is a penalty marker on the field.
Probably a little unnecessary roughness or late hit.
It'll be personal foul on Camanche. So that'll be another 15 yards. And that'll be good enough for a Mid-Prairie first down. And Mid-Prairie taking advantage of some defensive penalties from Camanche after making one of their own.
And I mean, again, Vargas on that run, being elusive as we all know that he is, and shedding a few tackles, took a big hit on this side of our field, the near side, and ultimately that's what warranted the penalty.
Should be 15 yards from the end of the run. It'll be first and 10 at the Camanche 16. Gingrich under center, sending Justin Schwartz in motion. Two receivers to the left, one to the right, and Vargas in the backfield. And hands off to Vargas. Tries to get to the edge, and he's going to be into the end zone for a Mid-Prairie touchdown, but there is a penalty marker on the field. We'll see what the penalty is. And it looks like it's going to be against Mid-Prairie, so this one will come back, unfortunately. But another nice run from Ricky Vargas.
And he was just Vargas being very patient on the left side, waiting for his blockers to come and help him out. And eventually he got into the end zone for the touchdown, but pending this penalty, tongue twister there. This one looks like it's coming back.
Looks like it's going to be a correction. It's going to be a face mask, a personal foul face mask penalty on Camanche. So it will be a touchdown for Ricky Vargas. That is his second rushing touchdown of the evening, as Taryn Jacoby gets set to take on the PAT. And Carson Gingrich will hold. Oh, it's a botched snap, and Jacoby is going to get tackled at about the 17-yard line. A bad snap. That snap basically took that play out of contention. So 6:09 left here in the first quarter. Your score, Mid-Prairie 20 and Camanche 0. We thought it was the flag came from the backside, so we were thinking it was going to be at least a holding on Mid-Prairie, but we were fooled. It was a defensive face mask against Camanche. Obviously, Mid-Prairie declined the penalty, and the play resulted in that Ricky Vargas touchdown. So that is the second rushing touchdown of the evening for Ricky Vargas. And Vargas having himself quite the football game. We're not even halfway through the first quarter. They also have some select. This is the sixth rushing touchdown of the year for Ricky Vargas.
Really going back to that snap there on the extra point. It was high snap to say the least, but penalty will be assessed on the kickoff for that Mid-Prairie face mask, Camanche face mask. But the snap on the extra point, it was a little high to say the least, almost corralled it and tried to make something out of nothing, but again, decided to take the loss of yards there, and it's a very smart decision by Mid-Prairie.
Yeah, we'd like to thank Hills Bank, Wellman Family Practice, Kelowna Cooperative Technology Company, and Wellman Telephone Cooperative for making this portion of Mid-Prairie football on Wellman Access TV possible. As Jacoby gets set to kick off from his own 45, and that will sail into the end zone. That may, if he would have had a little more hang time, that probably would have landed on the track.
Kicking a little bit into the wind, I'd say.
Camanche will start first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. The Indians have really only had one positive offensive play, that connection from Baylor Krieger to his receiver, Hampton Grimm. And other than that, they've really all been either no gains or negative plays. Let's see what the Indians can do here on this drive. First and 10 from their 20. Krieger, under center, looks to pass, has a man open, and it is caught by number 10. That is Lucas Dahl, the 6'1", 165-pound junior wide receiver on the catch for Camanche. It is a gain of 9. It'll bring up second down and 1 for the Indians at their own 29. Again, the four wide receivers set, and Snodgrass will line up alongside Krieger in the shotgun. A low snap. And Kruger's going to take it himself. And looks like he's going to be marked short of the first down marker. So it looks like no gain on that play. Nice job by the Mid-Prairie defensive line standing tall. It'll be third down and one here at their own 29.
On the pass play right there for Comanche, the play before the run by Grimm, it was just the same exact route. And that slant right now, if it's Mid-Prairie, you don't want it to kill you.
Third and one, another low snap. Kruger's going to take it himself, and he's going to get nowhere. Levi Dua, the big man, will tackle Kruger for looks like a loss of more than one, more like four. And they'll bring up four down for Comanche. Looks like they're going to punt here. Nice decision. Looks like it'll be Dawson Sally on to attempt the punt. For Comanche, excuse me, and Taryn Jacoby back deep. That punt is blocked by Levi Dua, and he's going to get on top of that ball. Levi Dua having himself quite a night on the defensive side of the ball.
Really both sides of the ball. He's a very versatile player and just unavoided right there. Just had a nice runway and ultimately got the punt block.
A blocked punt for Levi Dua, the 6'3", 235-pound senior defensive end and Iowa commit. I think Kirk Ferentz wouldn't mind seeing some plays like that from him in a few years. First and 10 from the Comanche 15. Gingrich under center in the I formation. Two receivers lined up to the left. As Keaton Dua takes a handoff, and he will get into the end zone for a Mid-Prairie touchdown. Keaton Dua, 15-yard run. And Mid-Prairie is pouring it on homecoming.
Good, very nice run by Mid-Prairie there. Very shifty and elusive. And that's really what Mid-Prairie has over this Comanche defense. A little more athleticism on the offensive line compared to Comanche's defensive line. Ultimately, that's what Mid-Prairie used to their advantage and got the touchdown.
And 15-yard run from Keaton Dua. It's right now the score 26-0. It's the first rushing touchdown of the year for Keaton Dua, as they're going to go for two here to avenge that extra point. As the ball comes out, the handoff from Gingrich to Keaton Dua, and I think if Dua would not have let go of that ball, he probably would have got in. But nonetheless, 4:20 left here in the first quarter. Your score, Mid-Prairie 26, Comanche 0. This is a beatdown.
Yes.
Through the first little over half a quarter. And again, if you're Pete Cavanaugh, you have to love what you're seeing on both sides of the ball. After really, you know, three straight losses, you score 14 points against Washington, you score 6 points against West Liberty. You did score 31 last week against Mount Vernon. But to have 26 points already on the board about 7 minutes and 40 seconds into the game, it's got to put a smile on your face.
Absolutely, and as you mentioned, he's getting from all facets of the game. Running game, passing game starting to move the ball a little bit, as well as the special teams as they're starting to get pressure, and ultimately that punt block set up the touchdown.
Taryn Jacoby set to kick off to the Indians. Is away, a high end over end kick, and it will get fielded inside the five. Kick is fielded by number two for Comanche. That is Eric Campy, and he will get to about the 20-yard line. And that's where the Indians will start their next offensive possession. It'll be first and 10 for the Indians at their own 20. They've started every single one of their drives at the 20-yard line. They really haven't gone very far. As Kruger will line up in the shotgun. A four wide receiver set and an empty backfield. Kruger back to pass. Avoids the pressure, and he will not avoid that pressure. Ricky Vargas on the sack for Mid-Prairie. And it is a loss of about four. Give him loss of two, excuse me. It needs to be second down and 12. for Camanche at their own 18. The first sack of the year for Ricky Vargas. Krieger back to pass. He's going to go deep. And he overthrows everybody. Try to go over the top of the defense. And he overthrew his receiver. It'll be third down and 12 upcoming for Camanche.
I guess if you're Camanche, just that play right there, air it out, eventually sets up the short to intermediate passes and the run game.
The Indians really have not done anything offensively except for one first down reception. Third and 12 here for Camanche at their own 18. Krieger back to pass. He's going deep again. And it's incomplete. Justin Schwartz looks like he had a read on that ball, but ultimately could not come down with it. It'll be fourth down upcoming for Camanche. And it looks like another punt will be upcoming. Be Dawson Sally on to punt for Camanche, and Terry Jacoby, Ricky Vargas back deep for Mid-Prairie. Set up at about their own 40-yard line. Coming up on 3.5 minutes remaining here in this first quarter. As Sally does a little bit of a rugby-style kick, and it will get behind Jacoby, but he will field it at about his own 40. As Jacoby has some daylight into Camanche territory, and he will get forced out of bounds at about the Camanche 32. Nice return there from Taron Jacoby.
Had the ball go behind him, did Terrence Jacoby, and again, that was almost an absolute disaster waiting for the ball to come down instead of going up and catching the rugby-style kick, but puts his team in solid field position at the Camanche 32.
Mid-Prairie once again starting this offensive drive in Camanche territory. First and 10 at the Camanche 32. Mid-Prairie lining up in the I formation with two receivers lined up to the left. Gingrich rolling out to his left, has a man deep, and it will fall incomplete. He had Carter Rainier beat, but he just overthrew him. But a little bit too much on that football, and it'll be second down and 10.
So a really good throw on the run if you're the Mid-Prairie quarterback. Very good job there.
Rainier had his man beat. But, again, a little bit too much mustard on that football from Carson Gingrich. And Mid-Prairie finding the end zone three times already. Coming up on 3 minutes remaining here in this first quarter. Second and 10. Vargas will line up in the backfield, and Gingrich will send Justin Schwartz in motion. The handoff to Ricky Vargas. Breaks a couple tackles. He's still on his feet. Basically took the entire Camanche defense to tackle him. Brings a very hard-earned, it's like about 5 yards. He'll bring up a third down and about five upcoming.
Little low center of gravity for Ricky Vargas. And again, he just kept on turning the legs and trying to get upfield and almost broke open for a longer run.
Give him four. This will be third and six for Mid-Prairie at the Camanche 28. Coming up on 2.5 minutes remaining here in this first quarter. Mid-Prairie will line up in the I formation with two receivers to the left. Gingrich rolling out to his left, and he's going to take it himself for the first down and more. There's a fumble on the play. And looks like it was recovered by Camanche.
And Camanche looks like they had jumped on the Indians.
A little bit of a weird play, almost like it was the same play they tried on their previous passing play for Mid-Prairie, but Carson Gingrich took it himself, and ultimately he got tagged and fumbled, and then Camanche on the recovery fumbled again. But luckily for them, they recovered deep into their own territory, however.
Well, it looked like from our vantage point, Gingrich got out of bounds, but you know, from the far sidelines, we can't see much over there. But honestly, it was a fumble. As Krieger, Jason too, again, reading that snap count perfectly, and the pass will fall incomplete. The intended receiver is Logan Coy, the 5'9 junior receiver. It'll be second down and 10. Again, Jason, too, doing a good job so far of reading that snap count. And he, so far, he's done that perfectly. Second and 10 at the Camanche 13. Krieger line up in the shotgun. Four wide receiver set. Krieger back to pass. Has a man open, and it is caught by Hampton Grimm. Hampton Grimm seems to be the go-to guy for Baylor. Krieger. And Hampton Grimm is indeed the leading receiver for Camanche coming into this game. He had 10 catches for 145 yards so far on the season. It'll be third down and 8 from the Camanche 15. Krieger in the shotgun, a four wide receiver set. And Krieger will throw, but the pass is incomplete, intended for Lucas Dahl. And yet another fourth down here for Camanche. Looks like they're going to punt, and they will not be able to take advantage of that turnover. So Dawson Sally back on to punt for Camanche, and Taryn Jacoby and Ricky Vargas back deep for Mid-Prairie. Snap is good, the kick is good, and it'll be fielded by Taryn Jacoby. And it's going to be a block in the back against Mid-Prairie. Not a good decision there by number 55. It was Josh Slawbaugh, the junior. It was a clear block in the back, and that's going to cost Mid-Prairie 10 yards.
A little bit of an unnecessary block as the returner was already past them and just got a little bit excited and wanted to make a hit. But I like the aggressiveness, but it does pay a price.
There was really nobody else around them, so the view from the ref was clear as day.
Yeah, there was a second as flag on that too, guys. Based on the fact that there was looked like another block in the back on command as well.
As the referees are converging.
Might be a block in the back for Camanche as well.
So there's two penalty flags on the field. We'll see what the head ref has decided to call as he jogs over to the Mid-Prairie sideline, and head coach Pete Cavanaugh wants an explanation of what's going on. So we got the illegal block in the back. So there's an illegal block in the back on Camanche, and that penalty is declined. And then it was offsetting penalties. So the ball will stay where it is. And it'll be marked at the Camanche 40-yard line. Excuse me. Going to be at midfield instead of the 40. And it is homecoming today here in Wellman. We'll have the homecoming court at halftime and also have a performance from the marching band. It'll be first and 10 for Mid-Prairie at the Camanche 49. Kingers will line up under central, single receivers on each side. Sends Keaton Dua into motion. Dua gets the handoff and has some daylight. He's got a first down and more. There's another penalty marker on the field. As the referee throws his hat up to the air as far as he can. You know what that was for. Yeah, and the
this would be like a little bit of a gravity lab in science.
There you go.
Might be a physics guy.
Well, we have a moment. We'd like to thank our sponsors once again. Hills Bank for all your banking needs. Wellman Family Practice, we remind you they are accepting new patients. The Kelowna Cooperative Technology Company and Wellman Telephone Cooperative bring you this portion of Mid-Prairie Football here on Wellman Access TV. As it looks like we may finally get an explanation from RF. That's going to be penalty again. Another more offsetting penalties. Maybe offsetting personal fouls. Holding against Mid-Prairie and personal foul on Camanche. So it's been a little bit of some extracurricular activity between these two teams so far. And we got 1:11 left here in the first quarter. as the ball will be marked at the Camanche 30. If they're going to take that personal foul, the first and 10 for Mid-Prairie at the Camanche 30. As Gingrich will line up under center. Two receivers to his left, one to his right. And looks like Ricky Vargas in the backfield. Slight delay changing the game balls from the Camanche side to the Mid-Prairie side. So we get the okay to get back into action. Gingrich will send his receiver into motion. Gingrich rolling out to his right. Has a man open, and it is Levi Dua, but he overthrew him and is incomplete.
Had some pressure there by the Camanche defensive end, linebacker Brennan Vogel coming out the right side. So his blind side for the Mid-Prairie quarterback, Carson Gingrich, just a little bit exposed as he started to roll out, and he did overthrow his receiver, but it was a good overthrow, almost essentially throwing it away.
Yeah, Gingrich got a little bit too excited there. Second down and 10 for Mid-Prairie at the Camanche 30. Gingrich lining up under center, one receiver to the left, two to the right, and he will hand off to Ricky Vargas, who has a hole and more. 10, 5, touchdown Mid-Prairie, Ricky Vargas, 30 yards to the house. And the third rushing touchdown of the evening for Ricky Vargas. And pending the PAT, Mid-Prairie will have a 33-0 lead.
It's just one cut and he's gone. Ricky Vargas, all he needed was that one cut and he was gone. And he has this breakaway speed to get away from the Camanche defenders.
Taryn Jacoby on to attempt the PAT. Snap is good, the kick is up, and it is good for Taryn Jacoby. 58 seconds left here in the first quarter. Your score, Mid-Prairie 33, Camanche 0.
Just an all-out Mid-Prairie party right now on the field. They have all the control in the game. They're winning the turnover battle and definitely gaining their yards on the run. But if you're Camanche, you just want to put together a sustainable drive, not necessarily points, but as long as you can move the ball and get the Mid-Prairie defense on their toes a little bit, maybe you can make something out of nothing here.
We talked about it in the pregame show. Yeah, this Camanche team has had a habit of having these blowout games. Their first game of the year against Bellevue, they lost 54-0. The next game at Monticello, they lost 32-6. Then they went to Mount Vernon and lost 78-0. And they lost last week against Williamsburg 55-7. So, say it's been a struggle for the Indians, maybe a bit of an understatement. As Taryn Jacoby, once again, set to kick off to the Indians. Mason Lanhart and Eric Campy back deep for Camanche, set up at about their own 5-yard line. The kick from Jacoby, a high end-over-end kick, and that will sail into the end zone for a touchback. So once again, Camanche will start their drive at the 20-yard line. There is a late flag, though. So we'll see what this is. It's been, again, a lot of extracurricular activities between these two teams once the whistle's blown. So I wouldn't be surprised if that's another indication of it. I didn't see anything.
I did not either. It is getting a little chippy, but if you're both teams, you just want to keep your composure and not let this get out of hand.
Especially if you're Camanche, I can understand it. You're down 33-0 when it's not even the end of the first quarter. But you got to have some restraint here as this game may already be getting out of hand. Yeah, we got a personal foul call. We're going to have offsetting personal foul calls on both teams. So, again, the extracurricular activities continue. It'll be first and 10 for Camanche at their own 20-yard line as Baylor Krieger will line up under shotgun and in the I formation. One receiver to the left. The toss to Hampton Grimm has some daylight, and yet another penalty marker on the field. Spending a lot of dirty laundry on the field so far through this first quarter, which seems like it will take forever.
Seemed like, from our vantage point, looked like a little bit of a horse collar tackle, but it's not. It's a face mask against Mid-Prairie.
That's right. A face mask against Mid-Prairie, so that will cost the Golden Hawks some yards. Exactly 15 yards, to be exact.
That penalty will be 15 yards against the Golden Hawks.
Camanche will have first and 10 at their own 40. I believe this is the furthest they've been from their own goal line so far here tonight. So we're under a minute remaining here in this first quarter. Again, the Indians lining up in the I formation with a single receiver to the left. Krieger faked the handoff, and he gets met by a host of Mid-Prairie defenders. Ricky Vargas and Levi Duo were among them, as was Josh Slabaugh.
Just a little bit of a broken play if you're Camanche, but it's for the decision-making right now for Baylor Krieger. It's just got to be a little bit quicker to keep the Mid-Prairie defense on their toes.
Indians once again lining up in the I formation with a single receiver to the left. Krieger rolling out to his right, and he's going to get sacked by Levi Dua. Second sack of the night for the big man, who really just overmatched Hampton Grimm, who was trying to block Levi Dua. And that's a battle that Levi Dua is probably going to win 99 times out of 100, as that will bring us to the end of the first quarter here from Dwight G. Sadler Field in Wellman. Your score, Mid-Prairie 33 and Camanche 0. We'll be back for the second quarter right after this. You're watching Mid-Prairie Golden Hawks football on Wellman Access TV. We welcome you back to Wellman and homecoming for the Mid-Prairie Golden Hawks. A dominant first quarter for Mid-Prairie has them up 33-0 after 12 minutes of action. Dylan Anderson along with Jimmy Nash here from Dwight G. Sadler Field. So we get set for the second quarter between the Golden Hawks and the Indians. Mid-Prairie really doing it on both sides of the ball. Offense, defense, they're making some impact on special teams as well. Really a complete effort so far for Mid-Prairie.
It's really the only thing that you can really wag your finger about is the penalties. It is getting a little bit chippy, but that's something we're going to look forward to seeing be changed by Mid-Prairie.
Krieger with the quick pass to his right is caught by his receiver. That is number 7, Hampton Grimm. And he's going to get marked about 5 yards short of the marker, gain of about 12 on that reception, but again, not quite enough for that first down. And an interesting decision ahead for Camanche and head coach John Romer. You're down 33 points and just starting the second quarter. Looks like they're going to go for it here. Be 4th and 5 for Camanche, a 5 wide receiver set and an empty backfield. Krieger takes a snap, rolling out to his right, avoiding the pressure. And he is going to get tackled out of bounds, and he's going to be stopped short of the marker. So Mid-Prairie, again, will take over on downs inside Camanche territory.
It's a very good play formation by Camanche. The formation goes to the left side of the field, and the Camanche quarterback Baylor Krieger rolls out to the opposite side of the field. Almost had a big enough hole to reach for the first down. Unfortunately, it was short.
Mid-Prairie taking full advantage of their turnovers from Camanche. They've scored on all but one offensive possession, and that possession was a fumble that was recovered by the Indians. Gingrich rolling out to his right, and he's going deep. Has a man open, and it is incomplete. Terran Jacoby, the intended receiver on that play, that could have been a touchdown. But nonetheless, it'll be second down and 10 for the Golden Hawks at the Camanche 47.
It was a 35-yard throw from on the run. And, I mean, I get it was going to your dominant side, but it was a very athletic play by Jacob Gingrich.
As we see Carson Gingrich line up under center in the I formation, single receiver set on each side. Gingrich will hand off to Keaton Dua, who has some daylight. And he'll get tackled at the 35-yard line. Another big run for this Mid-Prairie offense. We've seen Vargas do it tonight. We've seen Keaton Dua do it tonight as well.
Really, when you have that 1-2 punch, it's sort of, you see with the Iowa Hawkeyes up in Iowa City, lightning and thunder, and you have that in Dua and Vargas.
First and 10 from the Camanche 35. Golden Hawks lining up in the I formation with single receivers on each side. Gingrich will hand off to Keaton Dua, who has a first down. Actually, he's going to be marked about yard short. Or first down with another nice run by Keaton Dua, who's having himself quite the evening. It looks like they may... Looks like the head ref is talking with Levi Dua for Mid-Prairie, and I can't quite see the number for Camanche. I don't know if they've been going at it from the start of this game, but it could be two captains. Looks like it was...
Number 10.
Yeah, looks like it was Lucas Dahl for Camanche. Again, if you're just joining us, there's been quite a bit of chippiness between Mid-Prairie and Camanche. And some of that may be attributed to right now that Mid-Prairie is winning 33-0 with 10 minutes left here in the second quarter. Be second and one for Mid-Prairie. Gingrich will line up under center. Dua in the backfield and single receivers on each side. Gingrich faking the handoff. He's going to take it himself. And there's a flag on the field. Looks like... potentially in the area of holding against Mid-Prairie. See what the official call is. And it is holding against Mid-Prairie, so that'll be a 10-yard penalty. What was second and one will become second and 11 for the Golden Hawks.
Again, the penalties are starting to mount, and when you have an up-tempo team like Mid-Prairie that likes to consistently run plays and get the ball off very quickly, the penalties does not help the tempo at all.
Second and 11 from the Camanche 36. Gingrich lining up under center. One receiver to his left, two to his right. Keaton Dua in the backfield. Hands off to Carter Rainier, who has a couple blocks, and he will, a nice run there of about 5 yards, but nice wide receiver handoff from Gingrich to Carter Rainier.
The ball, it looked like from our vantage point, just came out at the very end. Luckily, it rolled out of bounds in favor of Mid-Prairie.
So it'll be third down and five for Mid-Prairie at the Camanche 30. We've seen Mid-Prairie run this jet sweep quite a bit, and usually it has a modest amount of success. I don't think they've broke one from the jet sweep, but that is a popular play in Coach Pete Cavanaugh's offense. As we come up on third down and five, and Mid-Prairie will line up in the I formation with two receivers lined up on the right. Gringrich rolling out to his right, going for the end zone, and it is incomplete. Taron Jacoby, the intended receiver on that play, he wanted a pass interference, but he won't get it. It's like Eric Campy on the coverage for Camanche, and it'll be a fourth down and five upcoming for Mid-Prairie. Let's see what Coach Pete Cavanaugh has decided he's going to do here. You're up 33-0, 8:38 left here in the second quarter, and looks like they're going to go for it here, fourth and five. And again, line up in the I formation with a single receiver on each side. Gingrich will hand off to Keaton Dua, who has some daylight and more, and he will get past the marker, and that will be good enough for another Mid-Prairie first down. So he got tripped, but nonetheless, a nice fourth down conversion there for the Mid-Prairie offense.
Almost made that last cut and kept on going, but as you said, looked like he tripped over his feet a little bit. Nonetheless, still got the first down.
First and 10 from the Camanche 20. Mid-Prairie lining up in the I formation with single receivers on each side. Gingrich take the handoff, and he's going to take it himself. And he's got a nice gain of about five on that run. Second and five for Mid-Prairie. It looks like there's an injured Camanche player that is being tended to. Looks like it is Lucas Dahl, the 6'1", 165-pound junior linebacker. It's being tended to by the Camanche medical staff. And he gets to the sidelines under his own power. As play resumes, it'll be second and five for Mid-Prairie at the Camanche 15. Mid-Prairie lining up again in the I formation with single receivers on each side. Gingrich handing off to Keaton Dew, who has a couple blocks, and he will get inside the Camanche 5. It'll be first down and goal upcoming for Mid-Prairie.
It's a nice tackle there by Hampton Grimm for Camanche. He's certainly playing both sides of the ball very well tonight for Camanche.
Again, Camanche really has about 21 guys dressed, so a lot of these guys are going to have to go both ways. The first and goal for Mid-Prairie. Lining up in the I formation with two receivers to the left. The handoff to Keaton Dua. He will get into the end zone for a Mid-Prairie touchdown.
Looks like there will be a flag on the play.
Three penalty flags fly, and we'll see what we get. As of right now, it is the second rushing touchdown of the night for Keaton Dua. We'll see what the penalty is.
I think it'll be either an unsportsmanlike conduct or a late hit on Camanche.
Gonna have a personal foul on Mid-Prairie.
Camanche.
So that 15-yard penalty will be assessed on the kickoff. Right now we have Taron Jacoby on to attempt the PAT. And Carson Gingrich will be the holder. Snap is good, the kick is up, and it is good for Taron Jacoby. 7:18 left here in the second quarter. Your score, Mid-Prairie 40 and Camanche 0. Again, we've seen the chippiness between these both teams kind of escalate, and I think it may have escalated a bit more after that last touchdown. I think Camanche is obviously not happy the fact they're down 40 points. We're not even at halftime yet. It's kind of shades of their game against Mount Vernon. They lost 78-0. So I think the key right now for Mid-Prairie is to not kind of bite into that. Because if you do, you're going to get called for penalties yourself. And you're going to let Camanche potentially get on the scoreboard.
And if you're Mid-Prairie, you mentioned not trying to scoot down to Comanche's level. But Camanche, if you're them, they're just trying to get into the Golden Hawks' heads right now. And I mean, it's not working right now because clearly, I mean, it's 40-0. We have just about 7 minutes and 20 seconds left in the first half. So, I mean, Camanche will get the ball back right here, most likely at their 20-yard line, as they have every single drive. But still, Camanche, just want to just keep your composure and try and move the ball.
And we'd like to thank our sponsors for making this half of Wellman Access TV football possible. Hills Bank for all your banking needs. Wellman Family Practice, we remind you they are accepting new patients. Kelowna Cooperative Technology Company and Wellman Telephone Cooperative bring you this portion of Mid-Prairie Golden Hawk football. Again, there was a personal foul penalty on that touchdown run by Keaton Dua, and that 15 yards will be enforced on this kickoff. So Terrence Jacoby will be kicking from right now the Camanche 45-yard line. So this should, again, he may attempt a field goal attempt from here.
It's what he's lining up for, going straight back.
Yes. Campy and Dawson Sally back deep to receive. And the kick is good. Literally through the uprights for Terrence Jacoby. And again, we sound like a broken record, but Camanche started every single one of their drives from their own 20.
And if you're Mid-Prairie right now, now you know that the range to the south end zone is 55 yards. So if somehow Camanche makes a terrific comeback, you now know that a 55-yard field goal is in your back pocket.
Camanche will start first and 10 at their own 20. We have struggled to get anything going offensively. As Camanche will line up in the I formation, we've seen them line up exclusively in the I formation for the past couple possessions with a single receiver lined up to the right. As the toss goes to Hampton Grimm, and he will get tackled a couple yards short of the first down marker, but there is a penalty flag on the field, and it's going to be a penalty against Camanche. So they get some good plays on offense, but they shoot themselves in the foot with silly penalties.
Penalty is on Camanche, most likely to be accepted by the Mid-Prairie Golden Hawks coaching staff.
That is exactly what they do. Looks like it's going to be a 5-yard penalty. Illegal shift is the penalty on Camanche. That'll move them back 5 yards. It'll be first and 15 from the 15. And Camanche lining up in the I formation with a single receiver lined up on the right side. And quarterback loses the ball, tries to toss the ball, and it is intercepted by the Mid-Prairie defender. That is number 55, Josh Slawbaugh, the junior, will get the interception. I think they'll call that an interception. But the quarterback, Krieger, tried to avoid the pressure and shovel pass it to his receiver, but it went right into the hands of Josh Slawbaugh. And Mid-Prairie will take over first and goal from the Camanche 6-yard line.
Just one of those fluky things that you do not think it will happen going into the game, but hey, it happened there, and there's a first time for everything in football.
Mid-Prairie will line up in the I formation with single receivers on each side. Christian Schwartz to the left, Terrence Jacoby to the right. Handoff to Ricky Vargas, and he will bulldoze his way into the end zone for a Mid-Prairie touchdown. Ricky Vargas from 6 yards out. I believe that is the fourth rushing touchdown of the evening for Ricky Vargas. 4 from Vargas, 2 from Keaton Dua. And we are a PAT away from having a 47-0 lead for Mid-Prairie. As Jacoby is on to attempt the extra point. Snap is high, the kick is up, and it still is good. 6:45 left here in the second quarter. The route is on here in Wellman. Your score, Mid-Prairie 47, Camanche 0.
And if you're Camanche, they blocked that extra point, and you saw the deflection ball started rotating the opposite way, but it still went in, still had the juice to get through the uprights.
is our corporate sponsor tonight. They have some select meats that the Boosters are cooking.
Yeah, if you're just joining us, both of these teams looking for their first district win of the 2016 season. Camanche got tripped up by Williamsburg last week, 55-7, and Mid-Prairie got tripped up by Mount Vernon, 49-31. And we'll be on the road for the next 2 weeks. Next week we'll be in Williamsburg for the battle between Williamsburg and Mid-Prairie here on Wellman Access TV. And the week after that, make the nice trek to Goose Lake to take on Northeast 2 weeks from tonight. The final home game for Mid-Prairie will take place on October 14th, and they welcome Anamosa to town. So three of their last four games will be on the road for Pete Cavanaugh's crew as we set to kick off. Jacoby, once again, as the kick goes out of the back of the end zone for a touchback, and once again, Banch will start at their own 20-yard line.
Might be their favorite number, and unfortunately, they do not have a number 20 on their roster. So, I mean, keep on saying number 20. It is not a person on Comanche. It is the starting field position for the Comanche offense.
As Comanche, well, again, line up in the I formation. They started the game with a four wide receiver set in the tailback lining up alongside the quarterback, but they have now exclusively gone to the I formation as another penalty marker is on the field, and the handoff will go to number 7, Hampton Grimm, for Comanche. We'll see what the penalty is. Looks like it's going to be holding on Comanche to another penalty here on first down. That'll move the Indians back 10 yards. It'll be first and 20 from their own 10.
The penalty will be 10 yards.
Might be a world record for penalties in this game. Guinness Book of World Records. You might need to fly into Eastern Iowa Airport and check that out.
Comanche will have it first and 19 on their own 11.
The first and 19 at the Comanche 11. So again, the I formation and a single receiver to the left side. It's Krieger. Handoff. That is Colby Snodgrass, the ball carrier for Comanche.
The Indians tackled by Dua, the golden boss.
Levi Dua on the tackle for Mid-Prairie. It'll be second and 13 coming up, or just under 6 minutes away from halftime. The second and 13 from the 17. So again, the I formation for Comanche and a single receiver on the right side. Krieger will hand off to his fullback. His Snodgrass, the ball carrier. And he will get maybe a yard. Don't think they're going to give him anything. So it'll still be third and 13 for Comanche at their own 17. The Indians once again struggling to get anything going offensively. The another I formation with a single receiver to the right. The Krieger, the toss to Hampton Grimm, will get nowhere.
Grimm on the carry, the Indians, tackled by Statler.
And Statler on the tackle. Caleb Statler, the 6'6 senior defensive end on the tackle for Mid-Prairie, and that'll force yet another Comanche punt. Jacoby and Vargas back deep for Mid-Prairie. They'll set up at about their own 47 as it's a angle kick that'll be marked Once again, in Comanche territory. It looks like it'll be at about the 46 of Comanche. So Mid-Prairie has gotten outstanding field position basically all night long. I don't know if I can recall a drive that started in Mid-Prairie territory. Except maybe that first drive. Vargas had the 55-yard touchdown. That's really the only drive that I can think of that started outside of Comanche territory. It'll be first and 10 for Mid-Prairie at the Comanche 46. Gingrich lined up under center in the I formation. Senior receivers on each side. Gingrich, the toss to Ricky Vargas, who has a hole. And straight up the middle. And he'll get tackled for another big gain at about the 27-yard line. Ricky Vargas having himself a career night here on his senior homecoming.
And Vargas starting to go towards the left at the very start of play, made that one cut and cut towards the middle of the field and ultimately picked up a bigger gain than he would have if he were to keep it out left.
Getting about 20 on that run. Again, Mid-Prairie in the I formation with a single receiver to the left. Handoff to Keaton Dua, who gets tripped up by number 5. That's Baylor Krieger, the quarterback, playing linebacker on defense for the Indians. That's honestly, that's probably the shortest gain we've seen a Mid-Prairie running back get all night long.
Yeah, it's
been a while. It'll be second and 5 at the Comanche 23. 3:26 and counting, remaining until recess. Gingrich will line up under center. Single receivers on each side, and Keaton Dua in the backfield. Handoff goes to Keaton Dua. Will bulldoze his way for another Mid-Prairie first down.
Tackled by Shaw for the Indians.
Runs him over and gets the first down.
The play results in the first down for Mid-Prairie.
The time ticks down now to just about 3 minutes left in the half. Still 47-0. And Mid-Prairie right now, what I feel like is working for the rushing game is their offensive line, being more physical with the Comanche front seven and just really having their way and ultimately winning the battle.
The toss goes to Keaton Dua, who gets a couple blocks, and he will get tackled at about the 5-yard line. There is a penalty flag at about the 15. Looks like it's going to be holding against Mid-Prairie. So, again, if there's a few negatives so far tonight, number of penalties, and then that one fumble by I believe it was Carson Gingrich early in the first quarter. That's really been the only negatives so far for Mid-Prairie. Of course, again, it is homecoming tonight here at Dwight G. Sadler Field. And I think it's going to be a happy group of Golden Hawks and their fans and their families as they celebrate a potential big homecoming win. And, you know, hopefully get their season back on track. It'll be first and 20 for Mid-Prairie at the Comanche 25. Golden Hawks lining up in the I formation. The handoff goes to Keaton Dua, who has a hole, and he will get to the original line of scrimmage, but yet another penalty marker on the field. It's really been a theme, really, the past two games. There's quite a few penalties in the Mid-Prairie Mount Vernon game last week, and now we have a personal foul face mask call on Mid-Prairie, so that's going to move them back even more. So now it's going to be first in a country mile upcoming.
It'll be first in what, 25 or 30?
Personal foul, face mask on the Golden Hawks.
Could be at least 35, first and 35.
Yep, first and 35.
Yeah, it's officially first and 34 from the Comanche 39-yard line.
It's the first time I've ever seen that, a first and 34 play. So we'll see what Mid-Prairie does here.
Golden Hawks need to get to the 5 for a first down. Line up in the I formation with single receivers on each side. Gingrich dropping back to pass, has a man open. And yet another penalty marker on the field The catch is caught. The ball is caught by Alec Yutzi, the 5'10", 180-pound senior tight end. But, again, another penalty.
Be roughing the passer.
Roughing the passer on Camanche. So they get 15 of those yards back. So instead of first and 34, it's going to be about first and 19 for the Golden Hawks. But both teams trading off these big personal foul penalties. And I think both coaches, Pete Cavanaugh for Mid-Prairie and John Romer for Camanche, has got to be frustrated with the amount of penalties so far tonight, especially of the personal foul variety. There's been quite a few of those so far here tonight. 2:16 left until halftime. It'll still be first and long for Mid-Prairie. And again, the ball will be marked, looks like at the 17-yard line of Camanche. So be first and 13 officially. Skingus will hand off to Keaton Dua. There's two more penalty flags on the field. This is becoming a penalty fest here, folks, and there's more than a few people who are frustrated with the amount of dirty laundry. It's another face mask penalty against Camanche. So it'll be half the distance to the goal instead of 15 yards. And it'll be first down and goal upcoming for Mid-Prairie.
These refs must be on an hourly wage because they're certainly clocking in their time tonight.
Well, there's games into a District 5 that are, you know, right now 50 or over 50 minutes ago. We're halfway through the third quarter. One update we have, West Liberty is up 12-0 on Anamosa with 38 seconds left in the third quarter. That was 5 minutes ago. And we still have 1:55 left here in the first half. As the I formation once again for Mid-Prairie, the handoff will get nowhere. Handoff to Keaton Dua. He'll get stopped for little to no gain. And he'll bring up a second down and short. And Mid-Prairie can get a first down without scoring a touchdown. And to get to the four-yard line, to get that first down. It'll be third and short, 1:25 remaining in the half. Golden Hawks again going in the I formation with single receivers on each side. Keaton Dua goes straight up the gut and into the end zone for a Mid-Prairie touchdown. Keaton Dua, rushing touchdown number 3 on the evening for Keaton Dua. And that is the 7th overall rushing touchdown tonight for Mid-Prairie. 4 of them from Ricky Vargas, 3 of them from Keaton Dua. And right now, we are a PAT away from a 54-0 lead. As Jacoby is on to attempt the PAT, the snap is good, the kick is up, and it is good for Jacoby. 1:12 remaining here in the first half. Your score, Mid-Prairie 54 and Camanche 0. Again, we'd like to thank our sponsors for making this excellent first half of Mid-Prairie football possible. Hills Bank for all your banking needs. Wellman Family Practice, who reminds you they are accepting new patients. And Kelowna Cooperative Technology Company and Wellman Telephone Cooperative bring you this first half of Mid-Prairie Golden Hawk football here on Wellman Access TV. Dylan Anderson along with Jimmy Nash here from Dwight G. Sadler Field in Wellman. In week 5 of the high school football season, and so far so good for the guys in black and gold. A 54-0 lead. Here, just 1:12 remaining here until halftime, and Mid-Prairie will get the ball to start the second half. So one last chance here in the first half for Camanche to mount some kind of drive before they head to the locker room and regroup. We'll have stats for you at the start of the third quarter, and boy, am I excited to see those stats. It's going to be some
Some big numbers.
Some nice lines from guys like Ricky Vargas and Keaton Dua. As Jacoby gets set to kick away, it's a high end-over-end kick, and that will go into the back of the end zone for a touchback. Again, first and 10 for Camanche at their own 20. It's about their 10th drive of the half, and all of them have started at the 20-yard line.
Not exactly digging into the playbook if you're Camanche. You're down 54-0 with just over a minute left. You want to obviously get downfield, possibly into field goal range. Not quite sure on their kicking game, obviously due to the fact that they haven't been able to move the ball, but we'll see what they do here.
Krieger back to pass, has a man open. It is caught by number two. That is Eric Campy. And both teams have all three timeouts. That is good enough for a first down. That has to be at least the probably second or third first down we've seen all night from the Indians. It'll be first and 10 from the Camanche 32. 1:06 remaining here in the half. Krieger back to pass. Has a man open and is caught by Colby Snodgrass, who is still moving. Took basically the entire mid-period defense to tackle him. And he will get, it's like a gain of about 7 on that first down reception.
Second down, 7.
As Camanche going back to their four wide receiver sets. And abandoned that a few possessions ago, going exclusively in the I formation. But now, down 54 points, they're going to have to air it out. Krieger's in the shotgun, four wide receivers, two on each side, and Snodgrass in the backfield. Krieger will keep it himself. He'll get tackled just short of the marker. Looks like Jacoby was in on that tackle. As was Caleb Statler. We got 19 seconds left here in the first half. Camanche still needs to go 57 yards to find pay dirt. And they're going to bring out the chains to see if this is a first down or not. It was marked rather close to the marker. From our vantage point, it didn't look like he got it, but we'll see what the chains say. And the chains say it is about a foot or two short. So it'll be third down and a couple feet here for Camanche at the 43-yard line. Measuring it again for some reason.
Just got to make sure it gets on the right blade of grass.
Oh, of course. It's still short. Again, a very excellent first half for Pete Cavanaugh's bunch. 54 points on the board, and a defensive stop in the way. Away from pitching a shutout here in this first half. Krieger back to pass, goes down the middle, and it is caught by his receiver. That is Hampton Grimm with 1 second left on the game clock.
Play results in an Indian first down at the Mid-Prairie 45.
And the clock will run out. We have reached halftime here at Dwight G. Sadler Field in Wellman. And as good as the first half as Pete Cavanaugh could have asked for. Your halftime score, Mid-Prairie 54 and Camanche 0. We'll be back for the second half and also with some stats between this 2A District 5 battle between Mid-Prairie and Camanche. You're watching Mid-Prairie Golden Hawk football here on Wellman Access TV. Welcome back to Dwight G. Sadler Field in Wellman, where the Mid-Prairie Golden Hawks right now have a 54-0 halftime lead over the Camanche Indians. Dylan Anderson along with Jimmy Nash here from Wellman. Let's take you through the first half stats. It was all Mid-Prairie and got started with a 45-yard touchdown run by Ricky Vargas. The 9:45 mark of the first quarter, make it 7-0. Then Carter Reiner had a 22-yard interception, returned for a touchdown to make it 14-0. And then another touchdown run by Ricky Vargas, 16 yards to make it 20-0. The PAT was no good. Keaton Dua then got on the board with a 15-yard touchdown run, and his two-point conversion rush failed as Mid-Prairie took a 26-0 lead. Then Ricky Vargas again, a 30-yard run, and the PAT made it a 37-0 lead. And then Keaton Dua, a 5-yard touchdown run at the 7:18 mark of the second quarter. And then another Ricky Vargas touchdown run, a 5-yard run the end, or with at the 6:45 mark of the second quarter. And Keaton Dua punching it in again with another 5-yard touchdown run. And that's where we stand right now. 54-0. Mid-Prairie in favor of Camanche. We'll take you through some stats. And, Jimmy, these are kind of mind-boggling. Mid-Prairie has 12 first downs compared to Comanche's 4. Rushing yards is probably the most interesting stat. Mid-Prairie has 22 rushes for 254 yards. They're well over 10 yards a carry. Comanche, on the other hand, 19 rushes for minus 7 yards. And total offense as a whole, Mid-Prairie, 26 carries or 26 plays for 254 yards. Comanche has 32 plays for 63 yards. That really tells you the entire story of this first half. It has been all Mid-Prairie.
And really, there's nothing else to really say about this matchup so far. The only thing that has been, as we've mentioned through and through the first half, is the penalties. They're starting to mount, obviously. I believe there's 17 or 18 penalties between the two teams, Mid-Prairie and the opponent. But still, it's just get through the second half, play a clean game, and Comanche and Mid-Prairie just, again, play that clean game, and Comanche will see if you can move the ball a little bit better.
And Mid-Prairie has gotten every single one of their offensive yards on the ground. They've only attempted 4 pass plays the entire game, and none of them have been completed. So Mid-Prairie will receive the ball to start the second half. Comanche won the toss in the first half, and they elected to receive. So they will get the chance to add to their 54-0 lead as we get the third quarter underway. And the homecoming festivities are upon us here at Comanche as Keaton Dua takes the return into Comanche territory. He's at the 30, the 25, and he's going to get forced out of bounds at the Comanche 20 as the student section had a, looks like a flower bit or something, and they are all covered in flower. And as, again, the homecoming activities are in full force here in Wellman. A nice return there by Keaton Dua. And Mid-Prairie will set up shop at the Comanche 22. It is a running clock because the lead is over 35 points. And it will stay that way unless the Indians can get that lead under 35. As Gingrich hands off to Keaton Dua, who breaks a couple tackles and gets a nice gain of about 5-6 yards on that first down run.
And all that flour, that could have been a few batches of cookies, but
yeah,
I mean still all in the, it's homecoming, all in fun, as we know, and it's really good for the student body of Mid-Prairie to see a really good football game by their Golden Hawks.
Gain of 6 on the play, second down and 4. Mid-Prairie lining up in the I formation. And the single receivers on each side. So Nuck and McCain in motion. Handoff is to McCain, who gets to the left side, has a couple blocks, and he gets the first down and more. Inside the Mid-Prairie, looks like they're going to mark him at about the 6-yard line. So it'll be first down and goal upcoming for Mid Prairie.
And the running back waiting for his blocker to turn the edge. Couldn't quite get that last burst of speed to completely turn the edge into the end zone, but still picked up a solid gain.
The first and goal from the six. As Gingrich will line up under center, Mid-Prairie again in the I formation with single receivers on each side. The handoff to Keaton Dua. And bounce off a couple tackles and we'll get a gain of about three. So it'll be second and goal upcoming for Mid-Prairie, already having a 54-0 lead over their 2A District 5 rivals, the Camanche Indians.
And starting to see some Mid-Prairie Golden Hawks that you would not normally see all the time. So everyone getting their reps, and that's important heading into the meat of your district schedule.
It'll be second and goal with, again, the I formation upcoming and single receivers on each side. As Gingrich hands the toss off to Keaton Dua, and he will get into the end zone for a Mid-Prairie touchdown. Keaton Dua from 3 yards out. And yet another Mid-Prairie touchdown. Right now it is 60-0. Golden Hawks pending the PAT.
Believe that evens up the touchdown battle between Vargas and his counterpart at the other running back position, 4-4.
You are correct. 9 total touchdowns. As the PAT is good from Taryn Jacoby, 9 total touchdowns for the Golden Hawks. 4 rushing touchdowns from Murky Vargas, 4 rushing touchdowns from Keaton Dua, and a 22-yard pick six from Carter Rainier. So 9:25 left here in the third quarter. Your score, Mid-Prairie 61, Camanche 0. And again, some other individual stats going into that drive. Ricky Vargas, 8 carries for 133 yards and 4 touchdowns. Keaton Dua, going into that drive, had 11 carries for 95 yards and 3 touchdowns. That has since gone up. He's gotten his 4th rushing touchdown of the evening. And again, Mid-Prairie doing all of their damage on the ground. Every single one of those yards on the ground. I'd like to thank some more of our sponsors for making this broadcast possible. Federation Bank, Iowa Technology Services of Iowa, First Class Apparel of Kelowna, Yachty's Hardware of Kelowna, and Yachty's Ice Cream Shop, home of the world-famous Kelowna Bar, and Easy Go Karts, bringing you this portion of Wellman Access TV's broadcast of Mid-Prairie football. As the kickoff is fielded by Camanche. It is a number that's not on the varsity roster. So again, we see both teams, it's like getting some reserves in there. At this point of the game, it's crucial to get some of these backups some key varsity reps, because there's only so much you can do in practice. And it's good for both sides to get some of these younger kids in there, get them some experience, because you never know when their time may come. You know, there may be a key injury here or there, and some of these younger guys are going to have to step in. As Baylor Kriggs drops back to pass, and he gets met by a host of Mid-Prairie defenders. Mainly number 68, Caleb Statler, who's having himself quite the night on defense. But that pocket collapsed in a hurry, and Baylor Kriggs really had nowhere to go.
Again, the pocket, as you mentioned, just collapsed almost immediately, and very good pressure by the Mid-Prairie defensive line.
And loss of 3 on that play as Baylor Krieger will line up in the shotgun, a 5 wide receiver set. Krieger back to pass, and the pass is caught by Colby Snodgrass. Looks like Slabaugh on the tackle for Mid-Prairie. So that'll set up a 3rd down and about 8 upcoming for Camanche.
In Camanche, I believe this was the first drive that they did not start at their own 20-yard line.
I believe you're right. All the other ones came from either the kickoffs going into the end zone or the kickoff returners turning the ball to the 20-yard line. Now we have 3rd and 8 from the Camanche 35. An empty backfield and a 5 wide receiver set for the Indians as Krieger mishandles the snap, still gets the pass off. It's caught by Hampton Grimm, who gets across the 40 and will get tackled a couple yards short of that first down. So it'll be fourth down and about two upcoming for Camanche. But at this point in the game, you're down 61 points. It's really four down territory the rest of the way. It looks like it is going to be that way. They're going to go for it here on fourth and two, as Krieger will line up in the shotgun with Snodgrass alongside him in a four wide receiver set, two on each side. As Krieger will keep it himself, and he's going to get tackled. Looks like he's going to be short of that first down marker. To Alec Yutzi on the tackle for Mid-Prairie, and that's going to be, if my eyes are correct, Mid-Prairie football, but they are going to measure it just to be safe. But from our, we're looking straight at it. It looks like it's about a yard short. So after this measurement, it looks like Mid-Prairie should get the ball back on offense. So they will have the ball, and they're going to be about a length of a football short. They're going to measure it again. Actually, they're going to be more than a little bit of a length of a football short. They're going to be about a yard short. So another turnover on downs for the Indians, and Mid-Prairie will take over once again in Camanche territory. The ball will be marked at the Camanche 41, and that's where Mid-Prairie will start their next offensive possession.
They must need the good old chain gain to get their 10,000 steps in, so they're working towards their quota as well.
Yet as the running clock is in effect, and this game's going to go a lot faster than it did here in the first half. We're coming up on about 2 hours worth of game time. It'll be first and 10 for Mid-Prairie in the I formation, single receivers on each side. As we have a new quarterback in for Mid-Prairie, and the toss goes to Keaton Dua. And it's a nice run. He'll get tackled about a yard or two short of that first down. The new quarterback for Mid-Prairie is Grant Boyce, the 5'8", 150-pound sophomore quarterback. And we've seen Tom Butters come in at times for Carson Gingrich in relief. But now we see Grant Boyce. He's again listed at 5'8", 150 pounds. And it's like they're going to say that is a first down. Initially it was marked short, but they are going to give Mid-Prairie the first down. Again, Carson Gingrich. Right now on the sidelines, as is Levi Dua. So a lot of the backups on offense in right now for the Golden Hawks. He's again in the I formation. Boyce, the handoff to the tailback. That is Draven Dempsey, who will thank you. Looks like a gain of about 4 yards on that play for Draven Dempsey, the 5'9", 175-pound sophomore running back. It'll be second down and six upcoming for Mid-Prairie, coming just under 5 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. And Mid-Prairie well in control of this game here on their homecoming. Get in the I formation, single receivers on each side. The handoff to Dempsey, and he gets met by the interior of the Camanche defensive line. Mainly number 79, Matthew Butts, in on the tackle for Camanche. Butts listed at 6'2", 300 pounds. Senior offensive and defensive lineman. It'll be third down and eight upcoming for Mid-Prairie. As we said, it's good to get some of these backups into action because you never know when their time may come. Third and eight from the Camanche 29. The toss to Dempsey. Trying to get to the sidelines, and he's going to get tripped. Kind of got ate by the turf monster there. Gain of about 1, maybe 2 yards, and it'll set up a fourth down. And we'll see what Coach Pete Cavanaugh wants to do. Looks like they're going to go for it here on fourth down. Really nothing to lose. The game is well in hand. And you give these young guys a chance to work through a high-pressure situation with a fourth down and seven upcoming. Mid-Prairie again lining up in the I formation with single receivers on each side. Boyce takes the snap, rolling to his left, has a man open, and it is dropped. Duncan McCain had the pass, but it is out of his hands. And Mid-Prairie will turn it over on downs. The second turnover of the evening for the Golden Hawks. They had their first turnover early in the first quarter on a fumble by Carson Gingrich that was recovered by the Indians. Now we have first and 10 for Camanche at their own 29-yard line, coming up on under 3 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. Again, the running clock is in effect, so these last two quarters will go relatively quickly. And Krieger will line up in the shotgun. Stongrass line up alongside him in the four wide receiver set. The pass is caught by Hampton Grimm, but a nice hit there by Duncan McCain, and now we have a late flag.
Going to be unsportsmanlike conduct on the strong safety. Gave him a little bit extra of a push there.
There's going to be a personal foul on Mid-Prairie, so that'll give Camanche a free 15 yards, and that will move the ball to about the 44-yard line of Camanche. It's going to be a little bit more than that. I think it's going to be 15 yards from the end of the run. So that ball will get into Mid-Prairie territory. If I believe I'm correct, but I believe this is the first time all game that Camanche has been in Mid-Prairie territory.
I'd say so, because, I mean, when you have about 30 total yards, obviously you're not quite moving the ball.
Krieger back to pass, and the pass is caught by number 21, that is Mason Lanhart. There is a penalty, another penalty marker on the field. This again is going to be a face mask on Mid-Prairie. That was a clear face mask by the Mid-Prairie sidelines, and that'll give Camanche another free 15 yards from the end of the run. And Camanche getting some free yardage courtesy of some Mid-Prairie errors. And this is by far the closest they've ever been to potentially getting on the scoreboard. It'll be first and 10 from the Mid-Prairie 23, a five wide receiver set, an empty backfield. Krieger drops back to pass. He's going for the end zone, and it is incomplete, looking for Eric Campy. It's like Terrence Jacoby on the coverage for Mid-Prairie, and the Indians taking a shot downfield, and fortunately for them, they just could not convert. It'll be second down and 10 upcoming for the Indians.
And Mid-Prairie right now, they're starting to be exposed a little bit in the pass defense, and that's what's happened with Camanche right now, is the pass game is starting to open up for them. That's how they're moving the ball.
The pass is complete to Snodgrass, and he will get enough for a first down. And the Indians are nearing the red zone here as we come up on a minute remaining here in the third quarter. And Camanche may be knocking on the door of a potential score here, something we haven't said a lot. Actually, I believe it's the first time I've said it all night. And it'll be first and goal for Camanche at the Mid-Prairie 10. See if this defense can stand tall and keep the Indians out of the end zone. Krieger in the shotgun, a five wide receiver set. Krieger back to pass. The pass is caught by Colby Snodgrass, and he's going to get a gain of maybe one on that play. Let me give him 2 yards. Actually, they'll give him 3. So it'll be second down and goal from the 7 upcoming for the Indians. As we may have time run out on this third quarter, we'll see if the Indians get the playoff. And it looks like they will. Back to pass, and it is caught for a Camanche touchdown. Eric Campy on the reception. A 7-yard connection from Baylor Krieger to Eric Campy. And Camanche is finally on the board for the first time in 2 weeks. It is their third touchdown of the year. And again, coming into the game with a difference of it was 219-13 was the difference. The snap is low, the kick is up, and it is good for the PAT. Dawson Sally on the PAT. So the end of the third quarter, your score, Mid-Prairie 61, Camanche 7. We'll be back for the fourth quarter between the Golden Hawks and the Indians right after this. You're watching Mid-Prairie Golden Hawk football here on Wellman Access TV. Welcome you back to Dwight G. Sadler Field in Wellman for the start of the fourth quarter between Mid-Prairie and Camanche. Dylan Anderson along with Jimmy Nash here from Wellman. It's homecoming for the Golden Hawks. And the Indians finally get on the board. The last play of the third quarter, a 7-yard connection from Baylor Krieger to Eric Campy. Right now we have a 61-7 lead. And while we have a moment, we'd like to thank our sponsors for making this broadcast possible. Federation Bank for all your banking needs. Iowa Technology Services of Iowa. First Class Apparel of Kelowna. Yachty's Hardware of Kelowna. Yachty's Ice Cream Shop over the world-famous Kelowna Bar. And Easy Go Karts bringing you this portion of Mid-Prairie football. Dawson Sally gets set to kick away. And the kickoff will be touched by a Mid-Prairie player. And he will get on it. That is Grant Boyce, the quarterback who came in relief of Carson Gingrich on that last drive. And looks, we'll see if he stays out there. Looks like he will. He'll be the quarterback for this drive again. The 5'8", 150-pound sophomore, Grant Boyce, is making, I believe, his varsity debut here tonight against the Indians. And we have the running clock, so barring any timeouts or serious injuries, this clock will keep running. Scoring plays as well will stop the clock. Right now, first and 10 for Mid-Prairie at their own 28. Boyce will line up under center in the I formation with single receivers on each side. Boyce with the toss to Draven Dempsey. There's a flag on the field. And Dempsey looks like he get about 4 yards, but the preliminary indication says that this penalty is against Mid-Prairie and it will be coming back. Potentially in the area of holding against the Golden Hawks. Get the call from the head official, and that is indeed the call. Holding against Mid-Prairie, that'll cost them 10 yards. It'll be first and 20 at the Mid-Prairie 18.
Mid-Prairie will have it first and 20 at their own 19.
Get on this special homecoming for Mid-Prairie. It's good to get this big win. And I think the team knows that they did not play as well as they probably would have liked in the past three games, as Duncan McCain on the carry for Mid-Prairie, and I think this is a nice breath of fresh air for Pete Cavanaugh and company, getting this big win and getting their confidence back, because their last four games, three of them are going to be on the road. They only have one more home game, and that is 3 weeks from today against Anamosa. So they're going to be on the road these next 2 weeks, and they need a nice confidence boost as they go into some very big games as we look towards 2A District 5. As Boyce, again, hands off to Draven Dempsey, and he will get about 3 yards on that carry. Shaw on the tackle. Carter Shaw on the tackle for Camanche. And it'll be third and seven upcoming for the Golden Hawks. Then Mid-Prairie in the I formation with single receivers on each side. Boyce handoff to Draven Dempsey, and he will get like a gain of about three, but it's still going to be well short of the first down marker. So again, we'll see what Coach Pete Calvin wants to do here. Got your young guys in there. Do you go for it, or you punt it away? It looks like Boyce is waiting to get the play call from the Mid-Prairie sidelines, and he will get into the huddle. So Mid-Prairie, again, will go for it here on this fourth down as Justin Schwartz comes into the game for Mid-Prairie. Again, lining up in the I formation are the Golden Hawks with the single receivers on each side. The pitch to Dempsey from Boyce, and he will get stopped. Looks like about a yard or two short of that first down marker. So Camanche will again take over on downs. This will be in Mid-Prairie territory. This will be first down and 10 for Camanche at the Mid-Prairie 37-yard line.
So a little bit of a defensive stand by Camanche right there. And it's, again, obviously it's not the outcome that you have so desired, but, I mean, getting a little bit of confidence in the second half, because right now if the second half were a separate game, it would be tied.
Yeah. As Baylor Krieger will line up in the shotgun with the five wide receiver set. Krieger going deep, has a man open, and it is caught for a touchdown. The second connection from Krieger to Campy. There is a penalty marker on the field, though, so this will likely be coming back. It's in the area of holding, but we'll see. Yep, and it is indeed holding against Camanche. So that touchdown play will get negated. A nice catch by Eric Campy. That would have been his second receiving touchdown of the evening. And that would have been his second of the season. He got his first one as time expired in the third quarter. So what was a big play is now a big deficit here for Camanche. It'll be first and long for Camanche at the Mid-Prairie 48. First and 20. Upcoming for the Indians as they will be in a five-wide receiver formation with an empty backfield. Krieger will be lined up in the shotgun. It's Krieger back to pass. Goes down the middle and it is caught. Actually, no, it's not. Incomplete. It's like the hit from number 12. That's Grant Boyce. But yet another penalty marker on the field.
I think this would be in the area, some sort of spearing almost. It's when you sort of thrust your body and lead with your head into the player's chest. I think that's what the call is going to be here.
It's going to be a personal foul. Yeah, it's going to be a personal foul on Mid-Prairie, and they call it Mitchell targeting. So we'll see. I believe the targeting penalty, whoever it is, would be essentially ejected from this game, but I haven't.
No one's walked off the field.
No one's walking off the field, so they will get a 15-yard penalty. It'll be first and it's like first and six.
First down Indians.
At the 33. The quick pass to the left is caught by Camanche. That is Hampton Graham, the leading receiver for the Indians. And Draven Dempsey on the tackle for Mid-Prairie. Looks like a gain of about four. Bring up second down and two upcoming. Coming up on 6.5 minutes remaining here in the game. As Baylor Krieger will line up in the shotgun with Snodgrass lined up alongside him. Fumbles the snap. The throw is complete to Hampton Grimm. Duncan McCain on the tackle, and that's going to be tackled for, looks like, no gain. So it'll be third down and two upcoming for Camanche at the Mid-Prairie 28.
The quick passes for Camanche, not quite working right now. They had more success when they go that middle to intermediate to long throw. It's starting to expose the Golden Hawks secondary.
Indians going with the five-man. Five wide receiver set. The quick pass to the left is caught. They're going to do a lateral, and it is dropped by Colby Snodgrass. So the back lateral to Hampton Grimm, who in turn tried to throw it to Colby Snodgrass, and that pass is incomplete. So it'll be fourth down and one upcoming for Camanche, and you know, no doubt they're going to go for it here. But a curious play call there. On third down, the Indians going for it all. As Krieger will line up in the shotgun with Snodgrass lined up alongside him. And Snodgrass will break a couple tackles and get into the open field. They get tackled at about the 15-yard line of Mid-Prairie. And that'll be more than enough for a first down.
As the clock ticks down to under 5 minutes left in this contest, Camanche starting to move the ball a little bit. It is mostly the backups for the Mid-Prairie Golden Hawks, but still they're getting positive gains and they're continuing to move the ball and score points.
First and 10 for the Mid-Prairie 15. A low snap had to be picked up by the quarterback, Baylor Krieger, and he will get tackled for about a gain of three. There is another penalty marker on the field. I'm not sure how the defender is supposed to pull up. So, in fact, this will probably be against Mid-Prairie. There's another personal foul against Mid-Prairie. So that'll be half the distance to the goal. And it'll be first down for the Indians. And we'd like to thank our sponsors again for making this broadcast possible. Federation Bank, Iowa Technology Services of Iowa, First Class Apparel of Kelowna, Yachty's Hardware of Kelowna, Yachty's Ice Cream Shop, and Easy Go Karts bring you this portion of Mid-Prairie Golden Hawk football. We first and goal from the 7 for the Indians in a 4 wide receiver set. Krieger back to pass. And he's going to take it himself, try to get into that end zone, but he's going to get stopped about 2 yards short. Nonetheless, a nice run there by Baylor Krieger. And it looks like they will be good enough for a first down. So the Indians did not have to score to get another first down. And right now it'll be first and goal from the 3 with 3:48 and counting remaining here in Mid-Prairie's homecoming. Mid-Prairie is right now having a 54-point lead over the Indians. Krieger back to pass, goes to the end zone, and the pass is caught for the Camanche touchdown. I believe that is Eric Campy again. Excuse me, that is Hampton Grimm on the catch. A 3-yard connection from Baylor Krieger to Hampton Grimm. And they have their second touchdown of the evening. It is the first receiving touchdown of the season for Hampton Grimm. The 5'9", 160-pound senior wide receiver, as Dawson Sally's on to attempt the PAT. And snap is good. The kick is up, and it is good for Camanche. So 3:31 left here in the game. Your score, Mid-Prairie 61, Camanche 14. And obviously,
they're winning the second half.
Yeah, they're winning the second half. But, you know, again, with the idea of getting your younger and your backups in there, you know, you may give up a couple scores. But, again, I think the refs kind of outweigh the potential for giving up a couple scores. You know, with the game, you know, already in hand, they're up 47 points right now, 3.5 minutes to go. I think you, I mean, you would obviously like to get have the shutout, but you can afford to give up a touchdown or two in this situation. Again, I think it's really just a good thing for this whole community, the team, the and the fans, to have this nice confidence boost after three tough games against Washington, West Liberty, and Mount Vernon. To get back on that winning track, and at the conclusion of this game, Mid-Prairie will improve to 2-3 on the season and 1-1 in Class 2A District 5 play. They'll be on the road next week in Williamsburg to take on the Raiders, and then they'll be on the road the week after that, make the trip to Goose Lake to play the Rebels of Northeast. Again, we thank Federation Bank, Iowa Technology Services of Iowa, First Class Apparel of Kelowna, Yachty's Hardware of Kelowna, Yachty's Ice Cream Shop, and Easy Go Cards for their continued sponsorship of Mid-Prairie football. As the kickoff is bobbled by Draven Dempsey, we'll see. Had some trouble corralling that football, and looks like he did get on top of it. So it will be Mid-Prairie ball. It'll be first and 10 at the Mid-Prairie 31-yard line. And with under 3 minutes to go, you would think this would probably be the last offensive possession of the game, barring a three and out. And they would be content with running some plays up the middle and potentially going home and running this clock out and celebrating the big homecoming win here in Wellman.
Ball will be spotted. Looks like the Mid-Prairie Golden Hawks 36-yard line to start out this drive.
Again, 2:34 and counting. Manning in the game, the handoff to Draven Dempsey, and he will get stopped by the interior of that Comanche defensive line, and he will gain about 2 yards as we have an injured Indian on the field. And didn't look like he was moving, but he twitched his leg, so hope for the best for that injured Comanche Indian. Again, with the game all but decided, and a celebration is on tap for the Golden Hawks and their fans as they will celebrate the big homecoming win over Comanche. There's definitely a lot of things you can take forward into the game next week against Williamsburg and the rest of the season, especially the rushing attack counting for 7 touchdowns.
Isn't it 8? Because didn't we talked about how the touchdown battle was evened up?
That's very true. Because Carter Reiner had that interception. Actually, there's been 9 touchdowns. Mm-hmm. Excuse me. I stand corrected. 4 from Vargas, 4 from Dua, and then the pick 6 from Carter Reiner. I apologize for that error. But, a very, very good.
You lose track sometimes.
Yeah, I know. It happens. It happens to the best of us.
Absolutely.
Again, we'd like to once again thank our sponsors, Federation Bank, Iowa Technology Services of Iowa, First Class Apparel of Kelowna, Yachty's Hardware of Kelowna, Yachty's Ice Cream Shop, home of the world-famous Kelowna Bar, and Easy Go Karts, bringing you this portion of Wellman Access TV's broadcast of Mid-Prairie football, as looks like the injured Comanche player, looks like number 72, Nicholas Bouchard, he's 6 foot, 240-pound senior lineman, and walking gingerly to that sideline. So we hope for the best for Nicholas. And Jimmy, you haven't had the experience of talking about the world famous Kelowna Bar.
I have not.
You haven't even. I don't think you even know what it is.
I haven't seen one.
We haven't either.
It's been hyped up. I'm obviously from 3.5 hours, almost due northeast of here. So Kelowna Bar will be.
But
it's something to experience.
Basically what the Kelowna Bar is, it's ice cream covered in chocolate and then dusted with graham crackers, graham cracker dust. I have not had one before. It sounds amazing. And I think our good friend Larry Thurman, who our cameraman, may be getting a couple for us to see what that see what the hype is all about as that handoff goes to Draven Dempsey. And you know, we had a nice conversation on the way here talking about the Kelowna Bars. And we've talked about them for basically every week. Talked about these Kelowna Bars. And finally, hopefully going to get our hands on one eventually, and we've heard they're pretty good. They come up on under 2 minutes remaining here in the game here at Dwight G. Sadler Field in Wellman. We got 1:34 and counting remaining here in the game as Mid-Prairie is nearing midfield. Again in the I formation, the handoff will go. To number 26 for Mid-Prairie. That is, 25. That is Rex Peck, the 5'9", 175-pound sophomore running back, getting a carry. So you come up on a minute remaining here in the game. We may see one, maybe two more plays before the end of this game. Aaron Wellman, be second and five. Get in the I formation, and Boyce will take a knee, and the celebration will begin here in Wellman, as it'll be a one more kneel down away from getting their second win of the year, and this one's a little extra special here on homecoming, getting a 61-14 win over the Camanche Indians, and they will Mid-Prairie will improve to 2-3 on the season and 1-1 in Class 2A District 5 play. Comanche will fall to 0-5 overall and 0-2 in Class 2A District 5 play. Again, your final. Mid-Prairie 61, Comanche 14. We'll be back here in a couple minutes to wrap things up here from Wellman as Mid-Prairie wins their homecoming game 61-14. We'll be back after this. You're watching Mid-Prairie football here on Wellman Access TV. Welcome you back to Dwight G. Sadler Field in Wellman. It is a final between Mid-Prairie and Comanche. The Golden Hawks get a win on homecoming, 61-14 over the Indians. Dylan Anderson along with Jimmy Nash here for all the action. Go through some final stats before we get out of here. It's really the story of the game was the Mid-Prairie offense. 8 rushing touchdowns, 4 from Ricky Vargas, 4 from Keaton Dua. And they also had a defensive touchdown, a 22-yard pick six from Carter Rainier. Some team stats. Mid-Prairie had 39 rushes for 325 yards. 325 yards rushing compared to 11 yards on 24 carries for Comanche. And Comanche had the edge in passing yards. They had 134 passing yards compared to Mid-Prairie's zero. Total offense, 44 plays for 325 yards for Mid-Prairie, 49 plays for 145 yards for Comanche. Mid-Prairie also had 2 interceptions. They won the turnover battle. Penalties. Penalties were a big part of this game. 24 penalties total combined the two teams for 226 penalty yards. That is quite a bit of penalty yardage. Comanche surprisingly had the advantage in time of possession, even though Mid-Prairie did score a lot of their had a lot of their drives that lasted under a minute, so I guess you can see why that stat would be a little misleading. Big story, Comanche 1 of 10 on third down, 1 of 4 on fourth down conversions, and Mid-Prairie converted all 6 of their red zone chances. Some individual stats quickly. All right, Ricky Vargas, 8 carries for 133 yards and 4 touchdowns. Keaton Dua, 15 carries, 117 yards and 4 touchdowns. For Comanche, Colby Stongrass, 5 carries for 16 yards. And Hampton Grimm, 2 carries for 7 yards. Passing, Baylor Krieger went 17 of 24 for 134 yards and 2 touchdowns. Hampton Grimm, attempted one pass but did not complete it. Carson Gingrich went 0-4 through the air for Mid-Prairie. Mid-Prairie did all of their damage on the ground. And receiving, Hampton Grimm had 8 carries for 59 yards and a touchdown. Colby Sondgrass had 4 catches for 28 yards. And Eric Campy had 3 catches for 28 yards and a touchdown. Again, Mid-Prairie improves to 2-3 on the season, 1-2 in Class 2A District 5 play. And Camanche falls to 0-5 overall and 0-3 in Class 2A District 5. A big win for the Golden Hawks as they get their first district win of the year and have a couple tough games ahead. But before that, final thoughts from the game tonight. 8 rushing touchdowns. I think that's going to be my takeaway from tonight's game. 8 rushing touchdowns, 4 from Ricky Vargas, 4 from Keaton Dua.
And just an absolute beatdown, as we've been saying, from the Mid-Prairie Golden Hawks rushing, obviously, the entire way of going about it, as that is the only way Mid-Prairie actually moved the ball. But also something that helped out Mid-Prairie was the field position battle. As we know, they started, I think it was every single drive except one or two in Camanche territory. So when you have that short of field with a decent offense against a subpar defense, you're going to look to put up some points, and they did. Mid-Prairie scored 61.
Also on defense, Mid-Prairie had 5 sacks compared to 0 for Camanche. So that was a good effort all around for Pete Cavanaugh's bunch. A couple things. We'll thank our sponsors one more time for making this broadcast possible here on Wellman Access TV. Federation Bank, Iowa Technology Services of Iowa, First Class Apparel of Kelowna, Yachty's Hardware of Kelowna, Yachty's Ice Cream Shop, and Easy Go Karts brought you the second half of the Golden Hawks and the Indians. One quick thing before we go, we have to name our Freeman's Foods Player of the Game. We'd also like to thank Wellman Advance and Home Gas. So I talked to our cameraman, Larry, and I offered a little bit of a suggestion, and I think we're going to go with it. We're going to have Freeman's Foods Players of the Game, and they're going to be Ricky Vargas and Keaton Dua. Again, Ricky Vargas, 8 carries, 133 yards, and 4 touchdowns. Keaton Dua, 15 carries, 117 yards, and 4 touchdowns. So they will be the Freeman's Foods Players of the Game, and I think there probably wouldn't be any argument against it by the way those two ran tonight.
And no, and both of them combined having nearly 270 yards, and as we mentioned, 8 touchdowns. So just between them, they had just about 75% of their offense accounted for by those two running backs. So kudos to them for winning co-players of the game.
So again, your final here from Dwight G. Statler Field. Mid-Prairie 61, Camanche 14. We'll be back next Friday night in Williamsburg for a Class 2A District 5 battle between Mid-Prairie and the Raiders of Williamsburg. For Jimmy Nash, I am Dylan Anderson saying so long from Wellman. We'll see you next Friday in Williamsburg. Thank you.